Hey there, welcome back. So keeping plants alive doesn't have to be difficult. It can actually be a lot of fun. Here's West 2's Alex Alisi with this week's The Science of It.
Hello everyone and welcome to the Orlando Science Center. I'm Alex Alisi with another episode of The Science of It. And here we have Laura. And Laura, what are we talking about today?
We are talking about upcycled terrariums using mason jars and products you can buy around the local Orlando community.
Very cool. So what is a terrarium?
So a terrarium is a little planted garden inside of a jar or some other enclosed space. It's often like really small scale. You can add cute little props to it.
Okay, so what do we have in front of us here?
So right now we have all the materials you would need to make your own terrarium at home. We have some lovely plants from Palmer's Garden and Goods in Audubon Park. We have some gravel, moss, activated charcoal, soil, and of course our lovely jars.
Awesome, so this is all stuff that someone at home can actually go and get.
Absolutely, very okay. Accessible.
So how do we go ahead and make these?
All right, so the first step is you're going to pick your jar. So okay. I'm gonna choose this jar.
I'll take this one.
Excellent. All right, take the lid off if
and
you need
it. And these are just normal jars.
Normal jars, absolutely. This one I think was a pasta sauce jar.
Pickle jar.
Pickle jar, yeah, absolutely.
Cool.
So first thing we're gonna do is we're going to put a little bit of gravel in the bottom for drainage.
Okay.
Just enough to cover the base of your jar.
Okay, so you need to cover the bottom.
Yep, just a single layer.
I grabbed the biggest jar.
You did.
I should have grabbed the small one. Okay.
All right, beautiful. Next, we are going to add a little spoonful of activated charcoal. You can get this from any aquarium supply store or the pet store. So this is going to help prevent mold and fungus growth in your terrarium. So
okay.
Just a little spoonful.
Just a little bit. So the rocks help for drainage. This keeps the bad stuff, or tries to keep the bad stuff out.
Exactly.
Okay.
Exactly. Next, we're going to add our soil.
Okay.
So we've got a little scoop here.
And this is not soil just from the backyard, right?
No, this is like potting soil.
Potting soil, okay.
All right. I'm gonna just make sure that I'm not spilling soil all over the place. Warning to parents, this can get a little bit messy. So this might be something to do maybe on the back porch.
Okay, so an outdoor activity to make some terrariums.
Yeah, there you go.
Thank you. And how much soil do you usually put in these? Just a nice layer?
We want our terrariums to be about a third of the height of the jar.
Okay.
So enough that you'll be able to comfortably plant your plant.
I'm not doing this cleanly. I'm the child who needs to be out back in the backyard doing this.
Hey, it's a good example of what the kids' messes are.
Right, there
look
we
like.
Go. Perfect. Okay.
All right, next we're going to add our plant. So which plant would you like?
I'll take this one on the right. So
excellent.
What kind of plants can you put in the terrarium?
So garden shops actually have little plants like this labeled as terrarium plants.
Oh.
You can go and get. But they would be low light plants, ones that like a lot of moisture. So you've got a fern. I think this is also some kind of fern as well. So tropicals
okay.
are really good for
this. Nice. And you just put with the...
You're going to pinch the pot to loosen the roots up.
Okay.
And then you're going to tip it into your hand gently like this. Whoop. See, mine is a little bit root bound. And then you're just gonna delicately, I generally try and slide it into the side so
okay.
we can fill in around it as well.
Yeah.
Place it in there. You can also use these lovely tweezers.
Oh, perfect. Okay.
To move your plant around a bit.
And you're just trying to get this in the dirt.
In the dirt, and we're also going to fill a little bit of dirt in around it as well.
Okay.
Beautiful.
And what is the point of the jar? Why are we doing this in a jar?
So this will help make a mini biosphere. So ideally you would be able to put a lid on this once it's all watered and then it would just have a mini rain cycle inside the jar.
Oh,
so
cool.
You wouldn't need any added moisture.
And oh, also, so all the moisture just stays in there.
Exactly, it's also pretty.
Nice,
very
cool.
Very important part. Add a little bit more soil here to make sure that we have our plant nice and cradled.
Okay, how's mine looking?
It could look a little bit more soil. Just
it
little,
could look better.
It
I
could
got
look
it.
A little better. We want it, the soil to be even with the top of the, soil
oh, okay,
of the plant.
Okay.
So you see right here.
There we go.
It's got a nice flat surface now. That looks great.
Better. Okay.
All right. So now we're going to add some lovely finishing touches. We have some really pretty moss here, also from your local garden shop.
Okay. So this is to beautify it. Does
it
this?
It is.
Does this do anything else besides making it pretty?
Yeah, just makes it pretty. So
perfect.
You can take a little bit of moss and place that in there where you would like it to go. So I'm gonna put this little bit around the outside edge. There we go.
Very nice.
Nice little light accent there. And then you get to pick a little figure to go in your terrarium.
Ooh.
So we've got a little 3D printed geodesic dome, and we have some dinosaurs. Which one would you like?
I gotta go with the dinosaurs.
Absolutely.
I'll pick this guy.
Great. I'm gonna take this little geodesic dome, and then you can use your little tweezers to place that where you want it to go. Ooh. I'm gonna tip mine up.
I think I got a big enough jar. I can fit on in there. Nice, looks like a little prehistoric forest going on.
Perfect.
I like it.
That looks great. Tiny Jurassic Park, I love it.
So once you get your jar all set up like this, what would you do next?
So you would make sure that the soil is moist, give it about a day to make sure that it's not, and if you've overwatered it, you'll see a lot of water there and you want to be that to evaporate. Give it a spritz with just plain water, put the lid on.
And you're done.
Yep.
Cool. So this is something that people can do at home. You also do activities like this in the Science Center, right?
Absolutely. We've done this as a workshop for both kids and adults with varying levels of difficulty. And then we also currently have another plant-based workshop. We have our hydroponics for kids workshop running right now in March.
Very cool. Awesome. Well, Laura, thank you so much. And thank you for watching another episode of The Science of It.
Thanks so much.
Hey, how cool was that? So if you want to see all the other fun things that are happening over at the Orlando Science Center, it's open every day from 10 to 5.